Hello you all, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm Sonal and I make beauty related videos, and today I have did this makeup look right here using all Sugar Cosmetics product. This video will be all about first impressions on Sugar Cosmetics, so if you are interested in watching that, make sure that you watch this video till the end, because in the end I'm gonna be giving you all a lip swatch as well of three of the lipstick which I absolutely loved. And yeah guys, let's just get started with today's video. So first I'm going to be using a primer, and the primer that I have with me is this one. This is the Sugar Cosmetics Forward Stick Primer. So this came in broken, but it's fine. I think ये उनकी गलती नहीं है, ब्रांड की गलती नहीं है, but this is the problem with the delivery thing. I kind of like the packaging because it's so easy to use. It's a stick product. You can just like do like this and you're done. It is definitely like minimizing the pores and all, and I am quite enjoying it. And yeah, it's very easy to use, I think, so it's a nice product to have, because most of time we are in a rush while doing the makeup and we don't have a whole lot of time like in regular daily life. So I think it's a quite easy to use sort of product which is in a stick form. You can actually even use this in your car and all and do your makeup very easily. So with me I have the Ace of Base foundation stick. This is how it looks. I have in two shades now because one was gifted to me and one I have gotten myself. I have reviewed this product already, so you can check that video. I'll link that. You can click on the I button and you can get that video to watch. And it's a really nice foundation without having any sort of primer on. It lasted on my face for nice 3 hours. If I would have gone with the extra layers of like making your makeup last longer, like primer and setting spray, it would have lasted a lot more longer. So yeah, without any sort of product, it did last it on my face for 3 hours. And to be honest, I am a very oily skin sort of person. So yeah, so right now I have two shades with me. This is the 05 Mocha. This is absolutely my skin shade. Thoda sa ye yellow hota hai kabhi kabhi, but with time it just oxidizes and settles into my skin very beautifully. So the next shade that I have with me is 42 Glaze, and it's a little light. So now I'm gonna be just mixing both of these products and using it all over my face. It is a full coverage foundation. It's like a buildable coverage and it gives you a nice dewy finish, because I have used this foundation earlier and reviewed it. That is why I know about it. Now I'm gonna be using a brush to like blend all of this in. Talking about the foundation, I think me being the oily skin person, I am absolutely okay with this being a little dewy. You have to make sure that you set it nicely on the areas where you get oily, and I think it will work nicely on your skin. It looks absolutely amazing. I love the dewy skin look. Also, it's a stick foundation, very easy to carry. You can do it on the go, which is so again a nice plus point. The foundation is not collecting on my face, which is again a really nice thing. Like even before setting, it's not collecting on certain areas of my face. Usually what happens is if I keep talking like this, my foundation used to collect like right here, which is not happening yet. So I'm happy about that. You can see it is looking a little yellow, but it does oxidizes a little like beautifully with your color. So it will look good with time. So you don't need to worry about that as well. Now I'm going to be concealing my under eyes areas, and let's just get started with the concealer. So now moving towards the concealer, I have with me the Magic Wand concealer in the shade Corn Liche. So I'm really excited to try this one out. Let's see how it looks. Talking about the concealer, I think it is a nice concealer. It is thick in consistency and it does covers and gives you a nice coverage underneath your eyes. And I am happy with the concealer as well. Nothing is bad about it. I didn't find anything bad about it. So yeah, I am liking the concealer here. The contour forward stick. So we're gonna be blending and trying to blend this product out. I think the shade is really nice and subtle on the skin. So the product is quite blending nicely, but guys, I have to share something. The foundation, I don't know why it is moving a little bit right here. Like, it's not very visible on the camera, but when I see it in person, maybe because I haven't like set my face with some powder, maybe that is the thing. कि हो सकता है कि मैं जब अपने powder से अपने face को set करूँ तो ये सब सही हो जाए. But it is definitely moving a little bit. I'm gonna just show you. Like, it's just not visible on the camera for some reason, but it is. A little bit right here on the smile lines, it has started to move a little. Think about the contour shade, it's a really nice natural looking contour shade, blends nicely, looks nice, yet I think it's a nice product to have. Again, very easy to use, and yeah, I'm happy with the product. I am having no issue with the contour shade. Okay, so now moving towards the blush and give this face a little bit of more light. Let's just add some blush. Okay, so now with me, I have the Sugar Cosmetics Forward Blush Stick. It is in the shade Coral Climax. I love coral shade on me, guys. So, yeah, I am absolutely happy with the shade. It has a little bit of fragrance, but the fragrance is very mild. It is something like, smells like some flower, but the fragrance is really nice and very, very mild. I think it's a really nice color for dusky girls as well. To be honest, guys, I have used the Sugar Cosmetics blusher palette already, like this face palette. This is a very beautiful palette. I think it's a must-have palette, and it comes for $7.99. It's worth every single penny. It's just a beautiful palette to have. If you're a beginner, you should definitely give this one a try. They even do minis. They are really good, and let's see how the stick product looks. I think it's blending nicely and it is looking nice on the face. Again, very easy to use, easily blend. I think the stick product that they are doing, the contour, the primer and the blush, it's really nice. It blends nicely, looks very nice on your skin, does not move your base makeup, which is a thing I am very happy about. Definitely have no complaints with the contour, primer and the blush. It's blending beautifully and it is looking very nice on my skin. To set my base, I have with me All Set to Go translucent powder from Sugar Cosmetics. As you can see, it comes with a really nice packaging, and let's see, I have used this product once, so yeah. So talking about this product right here, which is All Set to Go translucent powder, it's a really nice product. And this product comes with a mirror, so it is a plus point. So this stops the powder. Let's see if the powder spills around and if this sponge is able to stop from the product getting messy. Giving it a nice shake, I'm gonna check if this powder spills around. You can see this powder didn't spill around. It's a okay situation. We can handle that much of powder. A little bit of powder did came out, but I think the sponge really stops the powder from coming out or spilling out. So it's nice product, nice packaging, really nice mirror as well. So you can like use it on the go as well. I think Sugar Cosmetics ka packaging, most of the product is designed very in a way ki aap usko easily kahin bhi use kar sakte ho. So I'm happy with that. Like if I'm in hurry, I can grab this mirror and I can grab all the stick products, and fast I can do my makeup and I'll be ready in like 20 or 15 minutes. So I'm happy with that thing. More about the translucent powder, I have used it to sort of bake, but to be honest, as it is a translucent powder, it can have flashback. It did made my face go matte and it does looks nice on my skin, yet I am quite liking it. It's a really nice finely milled powder. The powder is very soft in texture and it really blends nicely with your like, it really helps to set your face in place, and I'm quite happy with the powder. I have nothing bad to say about it, so yeah. So I have filled my brows off camera and I use the Sugar Cosmetics Blend the Tool Warrior 2 eyeshadow palette. Now I used these two colors right here to like fill in my brows, and we're gonna be trying out some eyeshadow shades as well and see how it looks. My face is like really ready to have some color on it, so let's just do our eyeshadow now. So I have swatched this product and it's swatched beautifully. It is a very nice product, very creamy, very pigmented. Some of the copper shades or some of the metallic shades are really nice and intense, and I'm quite happy with the eyeshadow as well. Let's see how this blends. I have squashed it, it's squashed beautifully. All the shades are really pigmented, and we're going to be trying to blend these and look and see how pigmented these look on the eyes. I haven't planned any sort of eye look, but I'm going to be using this shade right here. Taking some product and dusting off the excess. I think the eyeshadows are quite pigmented on the eyes as well. I'm going to just show you. I am dusting off everything that already was there in the brush. I'm gonna be taking a little bit of the product, not a lot, dusting the excess, and I'm gonna just show you how pigmented this is. You see that? It's coming out nicely. We're gonna be taking a little bit of more, dusting off the excess, and just placing the color. And you can see how beautifully it is coming out. Like on the eyes, it's very pigmented. It's not like you have to work a lot. And I think that is the thing I like about eyeshadow palettes, when they are quite pigmented and they come out to be like a similar shade as they are looking in the pan. And let's just concentrate on our eye look now. Also, I'm using this shade right here and using it to blend my eyeshadow. You can see it's blending beautifully. And as you can see, the eyeshadow has blended beautifully. There is no fallout, like zero fallout. And I'm quite happy about that. Neither is there any sort of excess powder in the pan as well. Like you can see a little bit of this, but that's fine. I don't have any problem with the eyeshadow as well. I haven't used all the shades, so I cannot like fully give you a review, but I think the shades which I have used, because it's squashed really beautifully as well, some of the shades were really nicely pigmented and really soft, and I kind of like could feel that the quality of the eyeshadows are really good just like using the same brown color underneath my waterline. Okay guys, now I'm gonna be moving towards taking this shade like right here, the nice popcorn shade. Let's watch it. And it's so nice and pigmented, you can see. It's a really beautiful palette, I would say. For 1200 rupees, it's a nice palette. Talking about the palette, I think it's a really nice palette to have for the pricing. It's a really nice palette because you have a lot of shade. You can do smoky eyes, you can have some shimmers, you have some olive green sort of color, you have this color which is really nice. Again, I think it's worth money because the quality of the eyeshadow is quite good. It's not like pigmentation nahi hai, aisa kuch bhi problem nahi hai isme. It's quite pigmented, has no fallouts. Metallic shades are really equally good, like mattes and compared to mattes, and I think it's a nice palette to have. Win-win for the price. Moving towards the mascara, I have with me Uptown Curl Lengthening Mascara, and this is how it looks. It is in the shade Black Beauty. As you can see guys, it has definitely did something with my eyes. Eyelashes. I am happy with the eyelashes because usually, to be honest, my eyelashes are very, very tiny and it's just not visible on camera if I am just doing my eyelashes. Using a mascara, I have used so many mascara. My eyelashes are just never visible on the camera. While searching for a drugstore everyday sort of mascara, you can go for this one. It definitely added length to my eyelash. Also talking about the wand, it's really nice. It is having a little bit of curve, which helps you to apply the mascara even more easily on certain areas of your eyes. And I think it's a nice mascara to have. Okay, so I'm back with my lashes on. I have changed my look a little bit so that I can give you a nice final look. And I have 3 shades of lipstick with me to like swatch and show. I will be giving you all a lip swatch so that you get an idea of how it looks on my skin. Now I'm going to be using a highlighter, and the highlighter which I'm using is their jelly highlighter in the shade bronze, and it's such a beautiful packaging. It comes with a stopper which is again cool, and this is how the product looks. It's a really fascinating product, I think. Okay, I'm excited. Blending nicely again, and it's giving me really nice glow. I also like to add a little bit rare, so I'm doing that.
That's good.
Can you see that? It's such a beautiful highlighter. Gives you really nice glow, and I quite like this product. So after trying the lipstick, I think this one specifically is a little too drying on the lips. I think it's a little way too drying on the lips. If you have chapped lips, don't even dare to touch this baby right here. But these two Matte Attack lipstick are really cool. They give you nice color, and I think it's really nice to have on your lips. It's a really nice matte lipstick. If you are a matte lover, you will absolutely love this. Also, talking about the highlighter is really cool. I enjoyed this. Nice packaging. Again, it's a jelly highlighter, very fascinating, and I think it's a nice highlighter. And yeah guys, that was it for today's video. I hope you all enjoyed watching it, and if you do, please make sure to subscribe to my channel, like this video, share it as much as you can, and yeah, comment what is your favorite product in the comments box, and I'll be back with more such videos. Love you all. Bye.